Yeah, hello, my name is Volker Schmitz. I'm sitting here and I'm happy to meet Dr. Artur Rakimov. And today we want to discuss cancer in relation to the famous breathing retraining of Dr. Buteyko. And we also will maybe discuss some other topics which are closely related when it comes to cancer, which is diet, for example. Mm-hmm. But let's start maybe with the breathing retraining. So what is your opinion about the relation between cancer and breathing? Do people who have cancer generally breathe wrong if there's something like this?
Yeah, thank you first of all for introduction, Walter. Yeah. Absolutely, if we start to measure, and there are studies, I have tables, graphs, charts showing that people with cancer have much heavier, they breathe at least twice the normal. And when cancer starts to metastasize and people have even heavier breathing, we measure the CP, we do the CP test, body oxygen test. Measuring breathing, we do this test, of course. Additional methods can be used as well, and I use for my students, which indicate that people breathe too much with cancer, that causes self-hypoxia. So in medicine, we call it hyperventilation. So people with cancer hyperventilate. This can be considered as a medical or physiological law now. Now, next thing, it's another physiological law when people breathe too much, too heavy. We are talking about autonomic or unconscious breathing. They get less oxygen. Now,
it's permanent.
It's permanent effect. We get chronic cell or tissue hypoxia, as we call it in medicine. So, cell tissue hypoxia, according to dozens of studies, driving factor, some studies say cell hypoxia is a central factor which promotes multiplication of malignant cells. Mm-hmm. So growth of cancer tumors has direct correlation with the level of tissue hypoxia. So the less oxygen, the faster tumor grows.
Yeah.
Now, so the opposite technique, and some doctors knew it for a long time, we use hyperbaric or pure oxygen. When we put people on pure oxygen, the cancer tumor starts to shrink. So that's relation to cancer and oxygen. Knowing about that, Dr. Buteyko and 200 of his doctors noticed many decades ago that people only practice breathing retraining because they had more than 100,000 of people with asthma, heart disease, other conditions. But many of these people, of course, had cancer tumors.
Yeah, sure.
And have breast cancer tumors, exceptionally common, prostate cancer in men. But what we notice that when doing breathing retraining program, when the students achieve really good levels, up to 50, 60 seconds, and this is how they trained in Russia,
yeah,
the cancer tumors disappear. So we would discard tissue left.
Yeah.
So the cell itself, the size of the tumor shrink to virtually nothing. And that was, of course, known among Buteyko doctors in Soviet Union in Russia. And because of that, one of the doctors, Dr. Paschenko, who was trained by Dr. Buteyko, he worked in Ukraine, in Zaporozhye, he conducted a clinical trial 120 people with first early stages of metastatic breast cancer.
Okay.
And all these people, all these 120 women with breast cancer, like initial stages of metastasis, when cancer cells just started to spread to adjacent lymph nodes.
Sure.
These people, all of them applied first three medical techniques, chemotherapy, radiation, and surgery. So we would do surgery, we cut tumor, we would do chemotherapy and radiation. And then, in addition to that, half of people, so-called experimental group, would use Buteyko breathing technique, breathing training, at the level of about 2 to 2.5 hours a day of breathing exercises for 3 years, which is a lot of breathing exercise.
Okay.
So for 3 years, we practiced 2 to 2.5 hours.
They also did physical exercises.
We did a whole program of breathing training. We started with about 10 seconds for the body oxygen test, for the CP test, which is very low, but I've seen hundreds of such students because when people hyperventilate, and that's 100% of people with cancer. We started with very low. Those people who practice breathing exercises, 3 years later, we measured mortality, how many of them died, because mortality quite high. So the common mortality for this type of cancer, because cancer is very kind of very different types of cancer and different stages of cancer, so there are many variables. For this type of cancer, usually the mortality rate is somewhere around 25%. So 3 year mortality in 3 years. Even though we do surgery, chemotherapy, radiation, all these medical methods, People often kind of, especially alternative medicine, they're kind of too critical in relation to these techniques. They're saying that maybe we are totally useless and so on. There are medical studies saying that they can reduce mortality by 10-20%. That's a little bit, 5-10-20%, sure. Very common. So doctors apply this technique because we are statistically effective. So we help people to survive longer and so on. Now, in addition to that, half of people experimental group practice this breathing exercise that I explained, and mortality in this group was 6 times less than expected. So this control group had about 25% mortality, but in the experimental group, this doctor who trained them breathing retraining, he actually wrote in the study that he lost only 2 women. Mm-hmm. So only 2 patients were lost in his breathing retraining group, but these 2 women. He wrote, in addition to cancer, we had diabetes and heart disease. So it was combined condition that was much more complex, much more difficult. Sure. Not just cancer, breast cancer alone, but in addition with diabetes and heart disease. And because of that, he wrote that these patients were not able even to retain their breath. They started with CP around 10-12 seconds. They could not achieve even CP 20 seconds because of too much damage, too much inflammation, other abnormalities present in the body. Mm. So that was a clinical trial, and it actually became, because of my studies in this area, and I had 2 patients, my students with cancer as well, and people who also recovered, people who were able to control cancer, to have normal life, to reduce the tumor size, to make tumor disappear. That became topic of my book, which I called Doctors Who Cure Cancer on Amazon, which I wrote like about 3 years ago. Mm. Because since then we had some new developments.
Yeah.
So new developments relates to like something which was started by Misha Sakharov, one of my students.
The idea was present before,
yes,
to include it into breathing retraining. Yeah.
Because the diet was a part which can be exceptionally beneficial for people. So now we discussed already kind of how we can apply breathing retraining, and people with breathing retraining alone can deal with cancer very successfully, but of course it's a very hard program because in order to improve, in order to achieve like clinical remission from cancer and have control of cancer, we need to practice really high amount of both breathing and physical exercise. Can apply Buteyko method, can apply devices for love, DIY. And so when we achieve breathing retraining, the immune system, when we have enough oxygen, the immune system is strong enough to start to eliminate cancer cells naturally.